Welcome to German History with a German accent. My name is Wolf, W-O-L-F, just like the animal. And before I start this video about Günther von Kluge, I want to wish all of my American viewers happy Independence Day weekend, since this video comes online on July 3rd or July 4th. Günther Adolf Ferdinand von Kluge was born on October 30th, 1882 in Posen, as son of Major General Max Kluge, who was awarded nobility in 1913, which extended to his family. Günther von Kluge was in the Cadet Corps before he joined the Prussian Army in 1901 as second lieutenant. During the First World War, von Kluge served as captain in the general staff of the 21st Army Corps. Serving on the Western Theater, von Kluge participated in the Second Ypres Battle between April and May 1915 and was severely wounded during the Battle of Verdun. In the interwar period, von Kluge remained in the Reichswehr and was promoted to the rank of major on April 1, 1923. On July 1, 1927, he was promoted to lieutenant colonel. And 1 year later, he became Chief of Staff of the 1st Cavalry Division, and on February 1, 1930, von Kluge was promoted to the rank of Colonel and took over command of the 2nd Prussian Artillery Regiment. On February 1, 1933, von Kluge was promoted to the rank of Major General and became Inspector of the Signal Corps. About 1 year later, he was promoted to the rank of Lieutenant General. In 1935, he became the commanding general of the 6th Army Corps, and on August 1, 1936, he was promoted to the rank of General of the Artillery. When the Second World War broke out, von Kluge participated in the Poland campaign, commanding the 4th Army. After the campaign was completed successfully, he was promoted to the rank of Colonel General on October 1, 1939. Günther von Kluge was also part of the West Campaign, still leading the 4th Army as a part of Army Group A, helping to complete the encirclement of the Allied troops in Dunkirk. For his achievements, von Kluge was promoted again on July 19, 1940. Together with 11 other generals to the rank of Field Marshal. During Operation Barbarossa, he still led the 4th Army before he replaced Fedor von Bock as commander of Army Group Center on December 18, 1941, where his units fought in Operation Typhoon, the codename for the assault of Moscow. In the following time, Army Group Center fought off heavy attacks by the Soviet troops and held its position during 1942. The Red Army was unable at this time to cause a breakthrough, but surely depleted the troops and resources of Army Group Center. After the Third Battle of Kharkov, parts of Army Group Center, together with Army Group South, attempted to conquer the Kursk Salient under the codename Citadel, but failed. On October 12, 1943, Günther von Kluge suffered a severe car crash that put him out of commission for quite some time. He became Commander-in-Chief West on July 7, 1944, and just 10 days later, he also became Commander of Army Group B. These positions made von Kluge very attractive for the resistance, but when he learned about the planned assassination attempt on July 20th, 1944, he refused to participate. After the Allied forces broke through the lines in Normandy, Hitler himself ordered von Kluge to issue a counterattack. This counterattack was known by the codename Lüttich and had failed within a week. Just a couple days later, when the Field Marshal was replaced by Field Marshal Walter Model, on August 19th, 1944, von Kluge sent a final note to the German dictator saying that he had always remained loyal towards him and that the suicide would be the only way to save his personal honor, and advised Hitler to do the same once it was time to end a hopeless battle. The same day, von Kluge took a cyanide capsule.